Hi there, I'm Jeff Goldberg and welcome to Take a Break from Code. When I talk to customers, they often ask me, what's the difference between low-code and no-code application development platforms? Well, there's a lot of confusion in the marketplace right now because vendors are jockeying for position and the technologies blur the lines between coding through abstraction and coding through language. In a lot of ways, low-code and no-code are very similar. They provide a visual development approach to rapid application development. Neither requires experience with traditional programming languages to create applications, making app development accessible to a greater number of people, specifically tech-savvy individuals working in business lines. Both promise to help professional and non-professional developers alike create applications with greater efficiency, thus increasing their productivity. And both strip away the overhead of standing up environments and maintaining infrastructure by virtue of them almost always offered in a platform as a service or PaaS form factor. But that's pretty much where the resemblance ends. Most no-code application development tools tend to be data-first, departmental productivity enhancement solutions like forms-based data input, simple reporting and dashboarding, and lightweight back-office automation. These types of applications are much easier to create with no-code tools compared to Excel or Access applications with VBA. No-code platforms enable less technical business users to build solutions fast because they are designed to solve functional use cases. They don't require the app creator to make considerations for architecture and restrict integration to vendor-provided solutions. While the ease, simplicity, and rigidity baked into pure no-code development works at the department level, scaling to the enterprise presents challenges like architecture constraints, increased monolithic application risks because of developer inexperience with application architecture patterns. In addition, most no-code platforms require that you deploy on their public cloud and don't have deployment flexibility to private cloud or on-premises infrastructure. From an extensibility perspective, because no-code platforms lean toward operational efficiency use cases, they don't possess the capability to focus on user experience and can't connect to legacy systems. Creating custom integrations for third-party solutions or homegrown systems are not supported by the vendor. From a governance perspective, there are no guardrails on application sprawl, causing data quality and data governance challenges because of multiple versions of the truth being out in the enterprise. Application quality is often not even considered in pure no-code platforms because they don't include the capabilities to do that. Low-code platforms approach application development from a software engineering perspective, which enables developers to take advantage of scalable application architecture and flexible deployment options. It gives them the ability to extend platform capabilities with open APIs, promoting reusability, and to exercise control with application testing, quality, and performance tooling, all while incorporating the high productivity techniques seen in no-code solutions to speed development through visual means. Low-code development is capable of handling more use cases than no-code because of their general purpose nature. Low-code platforms address innovative use cases with next-generation technologies like artificial intelligence, machine learning, and blockchain using drag-and-drop components built by technology leaders and the open source community. They also have the ability to create customer experience applications for mobile because they include user interface frameworks that implement design language and branding into your applications. They handle productivity and operational efficiency use cases spanning across departments and domains. And they support legacy system modernization, which brings to bear architectures with microservices, component-based development using containers, and continuous deployment opportunities for existing mission-critical applications. But here's the problem. No-code development platforms are perceived as too simplistic to support complex use cases, and low-code development platforms are considered too complex for non-professional developers to use. Let's compound that challenge with a couple of more issues. If you implement a no-code solution, you're going to be considered shadow IT to the greater IT organization. Once your apps grow beyond your business developer's ability to support them, what are you going to do? All that efficiency and cost savings is going to go out the window because your choices are limited. If you implement a low-code solution, it may make your developers faster, but does it increase the accuracy of the delivered solution relative to the business requirements? is time to value really reduced when your developers have to rework and fix solutions because the business remains outside the application development lifecycle? At what cost is it to the business to have apps faster that don't do what you need them or what they need to be able to do? The fact of the matter is, the problem goes beyond tools or technology. The problem lies in driving greater alignment between the business and IT in the application development process and partnering the business and IT developers in the act of application development. It is through this collaboration your organization gains application development efficiency, greater accuracy in delivered solutions, and time to value enhancing competitive advantage in the market. Finding a platform that fosters collaboration and provides no-code and low-code tools that work together and cater to the specific domain expertise of the business and IT developers is paramount to achieving those goals. So if you're considering a low-code or a no-code solution, you need to make sure you include these questions in your evaluation to make sure the interests of the business and IT are met. What does the solution do to promote and facilitate business and IT communication and collaboration? Is the collaboration integrated or is it additive to the solution? How does the solution support business and professional developers to create applications? And are specialist developers able to enhance the solution to deliver custom design language and custom code in a reusable format to business and professional developers? Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to chat with you again the next time we take a break from code.